أعوذ بالله السميع العليم من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. إن الحمد لله نحمده تعالى واستعين به واستغفره واستهديه. أعوذ بالله العلي العظيم من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا. We still continuing إن شاء الله in our beautiful journey, the best journey with Allah سبحانه وتعالى, with the book of Allah سبحانه وتعالى, to understand it, to apply it in your life, to know the message of السماء to the earth, Allah سبحانه وتعالى. The Holy Quran, there is nothing best or better than anything like Quran, كلام الله, the word of Allah سبحانه وتعالى, to get your nearness to Allah with it. That is the best, the Holy Quran سبحانه الله. فالقرآن الكريم, it's honor from the honor of Allah, the one who said it. It's كلام الله سبحانه وتعالى. Inshallah, we'll talk tonight, cover this ayah, verse number 25 in the chapter of Al-Anfal. Allah سبحانه وتعالى is giving us very good advice, otherwise it will be bad. It will be bad for everybody. He said, Almighty عز وجل, وَاتَّقُوا فِتْنَةً لَا تُصِيبَنَّ الَّذِينَ ظَلَمُوا مِنْكُمْ خَاصَّةً وَاتَّقُوا فِتْنَةً لَا تُصِيبَنَّ الَّذِينَ ظَلَمُوا مِنْكُمْ خَاصَّةً وَاعْلَمُوا أَنَّ اللَّهَ شَدِيدُ الْعِقَابِ. What is the meaning, عم الشيخ وفتنة؟ You scared us, يا مولانا. What is the meaning? The meaning is here. Allah is talking to the mu'mineen. All believers, beware of a punishment. Fitna here means a punishment. Fitna, that punishment could be fitna or killing or affliction and trials and more. Anything bad is called fitna. But in general here means punishment. That punishment can be too many things, not just killing, trials, affliction, poverty, tsunami, wind, hurricane, it's a fitna, about killing. Huh? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, beware of this punishment, fitna, which will not, which has the point, لا تصيبن الذين ظلموا منكم خاصة, which will not strike only those whom have wronged among you. Of, يعني gonna strike everybody, the good and the bad, the صالح and the طالح, those who are wronging themselves and others. But it will fall on the pious people also. What? يعني everybody. What is the reason? I can explain. If they become like the evil people, if they become like them, they are not even stopping them from doing their evil. And be sure that Allah is severe. وعلموا. Be sure that Allah is severe. وعلموا. أن الله شديد العقاب. And be sure that Allah is severe in punishment for those whom are disobeying Him. This ayah is opening our eyes to too many things. First of all, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is giving us a command. He's commanding us to be aware or to protect ourselves from any kind of fitna, trials, afflictions, killing, whatever bad, before it's become big. But it's become big. When you see something haram or something bad, try to stop it before it's become big. And it means you have to avoid any kind of sin, the minor and the major. Otherwise, if our society will not stop this haram, corruption, any kind of haram or fitna or problems or any kind of way you disobey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala from its beginning, subhanallah, that's gonna be a big problem later. For example here, whenever you see any thief, the thief when he start stealing, he did not start with stealing banks. He started with something little, right? Maybe, yeah, he steal an egg. Yes, the food of his brother, the money for his mom, his neighbor, something little. Nobody stopped him, and he's growing. Now he's gonna be a drug dealer, and he's gonna steal banks, attacking people, Arab, killing. Why? Because we did not stop this kind of fitna or problem when it's small. Maybe somebody gonna say, "I'm safe, ya ammi, ma li da'wa. I have no business with these people." No. Don't say that. Because if that thief or killer, اجترأ على غيرك سيجترأ عليك. if you attack others means he gonna he might be he can attack you too, because you are like anybody. And when you see some thieves nowadays, they are very smart. Do you think the thieves dumb, stupid? No, they are smarter than Newton and Edison. I'm telling you, the thief now is not going to the bad neighborhood to steal, because they have nothing. They look for the good neighborhood. You know, you see them, they are going for, what is the best areas here? Calabasas, for example, yeah? Beverly Hills. Yeah, they look for these places. Bel Air, yeah, see? That's why the thief is very smart. He knows how to hunt, where to hunt, you know? فسبحانallah, the way he attacked others, he can attack you easy. فدون't tell me, this is not my business. No, if you live in the society, it's your business. You have to, you have to try to make your society, your community safe by stopping these people. You know, when you become suspicious, you have suspicion about someone, call the police. What's wrong? Call him, yes. That's why. And if you say, this is not my business, I will tell you the story of the three buffaloes. You know the story of the three buffaloes? One of them was red and white, red, white, and the black buffalo. And when the lion came, was attacking three of them, he attacked first the white one. The red one and the black one, they said, this is not our business. Let him attack. It's okay. It's away from me. And after a while, the lion came and attacked the red one. He attacked the white, then he attacked the red. And later, during the time when he was attacking the red one, the black one, he said, I don't care. I'm safe. And later, was about to come close to the black one to attack him. And I would say, oh, this is my turn now. And the lion told him, no. أُكِلْتَ يَوْمَ أُكِلَ الثَّوْرُ الْأَبْيَضِ. You've been eaten since I was eating the white one. Why? Because you said, I don't care. If three of them, they stood against the buffalo, the lion from the beginning, the lion will never gonna come to attack three of them. See? So that's why if you say, this is not my business in my community, to fix something or to stop something bad or to try to... If you say, this is not my business, everybody going to say, this is not my business, خلاص, your community is done. That's why... أُكِلْتَ يَوْمَ أُكِلَ الثَّوْرُ الْأَهْلَبِ. That's why Allah said, وَاتَّقُوا فِتْنَةً. Be aware of that trials, afflictions, killing, problems. لَا تُصِيبَنَّ الَّذِينَ ظَلَمُوا مِنْكُمْ خَاصَّةً. That fitna, it will not just befall on those who are wronging themselves. And the pious people too. Subhanallah. طيب يبقى اتقاء الفتنة, how to be to protect yourself from this kind of fitna, to stop it from its beginning, to stop, to, you have to hold the hand of the one who's making this fitna. This fitna, there are too many things. Subhanallah. I'm telling you, Subhanallah. In Sharia, they said if somebody is killing someone accidentally, by mistake, خطأ, yeah, not intentionally. They say that diya, the blood money, who pay the blood money? If they did not, if that man, the killer, has no money, who pay according to Sharia? His family, from where side? His mom or his dad? From his dad, that's right. يبقى now his family, العاقلة or العائلة, the family, from the father of the killer, by if he's killing accidentally, خطأ, by mistake, not intentionally. Yeah. The one who's paying the blood money, his family from his father's side. When they see this killer, when he was young, he started making irhab to the people and try to harm people or something. When they stopped him, his family, his uncles and his whatever, they said, stop, you have to be good. This is shame for our family. Don't do this. He will never gonna do that. But if they leave him like that, he's gonna be in big trouble. And in the end, who gonna carry the responsibility? His family. They have to pay each one of them certain amount to cover this. Diya, the blood money. See? But that's why if they knew the family that the black sheep in the family, he's gonna bring al-ar or the shame for them one day, they're gonna tell his dad and they're gonna tell him this, you have to raise your kid good and you have to teach him, you know? Because this is ar, shame for our family, our tribe. See? But that's why if you know الغرم and the problem will touch you and will reach you somehow, you have to stop. This is a society. And the society is a big family, right? The society, it's a big family. If we're going to leave everybody, he can do whatever he wants. This is big, big problem. So that's why even الناس إذا رأوا الظالم ولم يضربوا على يده فإن الله يعمهم بغضب من عنده. When people sees الظالم, the unjust one, the oppressor, the troublemaker, making problem in the society, and the people of the authority that did not stop him, or even people that did not stop him, Allah will send punishment. And this punishment, fitna, trial, affliction, a tsunami, earthquake, anything that can come to everybody. Can come to everybody. Subhanallah. And if they will not stop الظالم, الظلم, corruption, and the oppression will be everywhere in the society, everywhere. Hadith narrated by Imam Ahmad, he said that Abu Bakr as-Siddiq radiallahu anhu, one time he stood above the manbar and he was talking to the people after he praised Allah Azza wa Jal wa athna alayhi, and he makes salah upon Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and then he starts making his khutbah. قال يا أيها الناس, أيها الناس أنتم تقرؤون هذه الآية, يا أيها الذين آمنوا لا يضركم من ضل إذا اهتديتم وإنكم تضعونها على غير موضعها. وإني سمعت الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم يقول إن الناس إذا رأوا المنكر ولا يغيرونه يوشك الله عز وجل أن يعمهم بعقابه. ده فصل في قضايا العقيدة والأحكام. يعني حديثنا رد بإمام إمام أحمد ذات أبو بكر الصديق, هو was talking to the people, خطبة. He said, oh people, listen, you are reading this verse in the Quran and you misunderstand its meaning. What is the verse saying? يا أيها الذين أمنوا, oh you who have believed, لا يضركم من ضل إذا اهتديتم. Don't worry about those who been misguided if Allah guided you. And you misunderstand its meaning. If you say, خلاص I've been guided, I'm in the masjid, the one who been misguided, let him go to hell. This is الظاهر من الآية. You can understand it from its meaning like that, but no, you have to go and search and to look for its meaning. You know, anybody understand the Arabic, who will say, yes, that is saying like that. Don't worry about people if I've been guided and they are misguided. Don't worry. لا يضركم من ضل إذا اهتديتم. You'll never be harmed about the one who being misguided if you of Allah guides you. This is not the right meaning. The right meaning, Abu Bakr Siddiq said, when the people said the meaning, when the people, they saw al-munkar, anything haram, unlawful, al-haram, and they are not trying to change it with their, to change it with their power, the responsibility of changing al-munkar to, by hand, to the people of the authority people, and to change it with their tongue, this is the job of the scholars, the ulama al-muslimin. And to change it with your heart, this is for the general Muslim people. عوام الناس. Somebody is not a scholar, somebody is not a people of the authority. At least say, يا رب, معذرة. This is my excuse, يا الله. معذرة إليك. This is my excuse, يا الله. I don't like what these people are doing. That's the minimum. Oh, no harm. Oh. Just say, يا رب, أتبرأ and I'm free from this, يا رب. I'm not with them. At least tell Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that. That's very important. يبقى now you have three ways to change المنكر. Number one, with your hand, the people of the authority, with your tongue, the scholars, the ulama, with the heart, this is for عوام الناس, general people, at least at the minimum. That's why Abu Bakr al-Siddiq radiallahu anhu said, this is the real meaning of the ayah, when people sees المنكر, the haram, and they are not trying to change it, يوشكو, Allah will be about to cover them with his punishment. Yeah, يُوشِكُ الله, about to. الوشك يعني about to. The punishment is coming to them. This is the meaning of the ayah. We have the Abu Bakr Siddiq when he says that, this is قول فصل. قول فصل is the final answer for what? For the aqidah, the creed, and the rules and the ahkam al-sharia. Don't tell me this ayah, the meaning is different. No. If you explain and you give the interpretation is different from its meaning, now we're going to have a lot of contradictions of the hadith of Rasulullah and other ayat. For the real meaning of this ayah, you have to try to change the munkar. الله يقوى الله سبحانه وتعالى. We have حديث عمدة. عمدة means main حديث about this subject tonight. حديث النعمان بن بشير رضي الله عنه. Let me read it in Arabic first and then we say it in English. That's a very beautiful حديث. Every Muslim must understand this حديث. صلى الله عليه وسلم said عن نعمان بن بشير. حديث narrated by Imam Muslim and the Imam البخاري. Both. Authentic حديث. قال مثل القائم في حدود الله. القائم في حدود الله the one he's following حدود الله. والواقع فيها. الواقع فيها the one he's opposing the limits of Allah. He's against Allah. He's doing all haram. يبقى we have two people now. One of them he's following the rules in الصلاة المستقيم القائم في حدود الله. Somebody standing in حدود الله the limits of Allah. Praying, making salah, zakah, hajj. Following the halal, away from the haram. He's in الصلاة المستقيم. This is القائم في حدود الله. The example of these two people. Rasulullah is giving us example to declare the ayat. The example of the one he's following the deen of Allah and the one he's not following the deen of Allah. Like what? كمثل قوم like a group of people استهموا على سفينة. يعني استهموا على سفينة. They were on a boat, سفينة or ship. And استهموا means they make a draw. They draw. One of them gonna be in the bottom and one of them gonna be in the top of the safina. This is they were equal in power. Because if somebody يعني had power more than other group, they're gonna beat them up and they will say, we'll go above, you go down, that's it. But they were equal. They were weak, all same, equal. That's why they said, let's make a draw, you know? And the draw comes, one group will be down, and another one will be above second roof, or they're going to be in above that ship. Yeah, they live there. They stay there. فَأَصَابَ بَعْضُهُمْ أَعْلَاهَا وَبَعْضُهُمْ أَسْفَلُهَا. One group was down in the lower, the bottom of the safina ship, and another one above, in the upper of the safina. فَكَانَ الَّذِينَ أَسْفَلْهَا. They are weak people, مساكين. Those who were in the bottom, they said, off. Every time we try to get water, we have to go second floor and to put our buckets and in the water to get it and to go down. This is too much work. What about one of them? He give fatwa. What about if we make a hole in the bottom of the safina, the ship, and the water gonna come to us? We don't have to go up in the upper the safina and to get the water. I told you they are masakin, yeah, the masakin people, you know. Somebody, you know, who gonna say that? I gonna make a hole in the safina to get the water? What is this? Doesn't work like that. فالرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم said قالوا لو أن خرقنا خرقا في نصيبنا. What about if we make a hole in our area where we live in the bottom of the safina? And we will not harm the people in the upper of the safina, you know, and we will not harm anybody. الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم said فإن يتركوهم وما أرادوا هلك جميعا. If those who are in the upper part of the safina will leave them to make this hole, they're going to be destroyed all. The safina will sink. You know, وَإِنْ أَخَذُوا عَلَىٰ أَيْدِيهِمْ if they hold their hand, you know, don't they do that. نَجَوْ وَنَجَوْ جَمْ they will be safe and all of them will be safe if they hold their hand. He said, the society like this ship. If those who are making corruption, bad stuff, those who are good, ulama, the scholars, those who are giving advices, they leave them to do whatever they want, our society will sink. And if they hold their hands, they said, no. Don't steal. Don't make haram. Don't harm. Don't kill. Don't make mischief. Huh? Don't take somebody's right. Don't. Our society will be very clean society. Subhanallah. That's why we understand from this ayah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَاعْلَمُوا you must know that أَنَّ اللَّهَ شَدِيدُ الْعِقَابِ. Allah indeed is severe in punishment. فالعقاب, the punishment will be for both الظالم والمظلوم, the oppressor and the one who been oppressed. طيب, the one who been oppressed, what did he do? He was quiet and he did not say anything to the oppressors. That's why the punishment will fall on him too with the wrongdoers. This is how to protect المجتمعات, the society, from all of this. That's why هكذا دين الله سبحانه وتعالى. القائم في حدود الله the one who is following الصلاة المستقيم. والواقع فيها the one he is doing haram and he is not doing the واجبات. What is the واجبات? الصلاة، الزكاة، الحج، الصوم، all of these واجبات. He's not doing all of this plus he's doing حرام whatever Allah forbid. If those علماء, the scholars, those the people of the authority, they leave them to do whatever they want, gonna be big corruption in the society. That's why Allah سبحانه وتعالى said, يا أيها العقلاء, those who have sins, try to protect your society. Because you protect your society means you protect your family, your kids, your daughters, your sons in the society from any kind of corruption. That's why otherwise the punishment will come for both the pious ones and the wrongdoers. Again, this is the meaning of the ayah number 25, verse 25 from the chapter of Al-Anfal. Allah said, وَاتَّقُوا فِتْنَةً لَا تُصِيبَنَّ الَّذِينَ ظَلَمُوا مِنْكُمْ خَاصَّةً وَاعْلَمُوا أَنَّ اللَّهَ شَدِيدُ الْعِقَابِ. This ayah, يعني يا جماعة, oof, comes, where is the battle of Badr? We've been talking about the battle of Badr and the kuffar and. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, don't imitate the kuffar. You are different. You have your identity. You are a Muslim. Let them do whatever they do. But you are different. Don't mix. Be careful. Guard your family, your community, your society, your kids, all of that. وَاتَّقُوا, be aware of this fitna. Fitna means punishment. That punishment could be killing, affliction, trials, and etc. Too many. Count a lot of bad things in the society. That's why that's called fitna. فالفتنة هنا in general means a punishment. لا تصيبن الذين ظلموا منكم خاصة. It will not fall only on the wrongdoers people. It will be the pious and the good and the bad. And you have to know, must know Allah indeed is severe in punishment. I'm asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Ya Rabbal Alameen, to protect all of us from al-fitan, ma zahara minha wa ma batan. May Allah protect all of us, Ya Rabb, our families, our life. May Allah protect all of us in this dunya and hereafter too, Ya Rabbal Alameen. May Allah make us firm in our deen, wa thabbitna ala sirat al-mustaqim, wa ja'alna mimman yattabi'una hududaka wa la yufarratuna fiha, Ya Rabbal Alameen. Wa taqabbal minna wa aghfir lana wa arhamna. وعافنا واعف عنا يا رب وعلى طاعتك عنا يا الله يا أرحم الراحمين. اللهم اشف مرضانا, اشف من كان منا مريضا, اشف مرضانا ومرضى المسلمين, وارحم موتانا وموتى المسلمين, وتب علينا يا رب العالمين, واشفنا واهدنا وارحمنا برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين. يا الله شاور us with your mercy, tranquility and rahmah and forgiveness يا رب العالمين. Let us go home tonight يا رب العالمين with ذنب مغفور يا أرحم الراحمين, and replace our سيئات with حسنات يا أرحم الراحمين. وتقبل منا وارحمنا واهدنا واسترنا واجبرنا يا أرحم الراحمين. وصلى اللهم على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. آمين.